Good evening to you as we go to air tonight. A flooding disaster is unfolding in the state's far north. Ex-tropical cyclone Jasper is going out with a bang, dropping record rain, causing life-threatening flooding. The airport and homes are tonight inundated, and there have been calls for dozens of swift water rescues. Kate Lamb begins our coverage.
At Cairns Airport, there's aquaplaning of a different kind. Aircraft underwater, the runway closed for a second time in 4 days as floodwaters rise to levels not seen since 1977.
So this is very serious and it could get worse.
The hazard clear, with rows of cars close to completely submerged and homes looking more like islands.
This is unprecedented, this amount of water that we've seen.
The unexpected aftermath as Cyclone Jasper makes a dramatic exit. It. 5 days of torrential rain.
I think our street's just a little bit underwater.
Roads turning to rivers, rivers to rapids.
And that is just crazy. No bridge there. That is the highway, man.
Water lapping at doorsteps, swallowing streets.
It's deep.
The cyclone is gone, but look at our back now.
Monster rain, some areas copping more than 400 millimetres in just 6 hours today, on top of more than half a metre in the past 24 hours.
It's akin to a Q100 event, the amount of water that's coming down from the tablelands, and it's widespread.
Rivers and creeks breaking their banks, residents holding their breath as the water inches closer and higher.
Stairs are under, aircon's under.
A tropical paradise swamped, leaving backpackers stranded. Paranella Park, a usually tranquil tourist attraction, now heaving. The famous Barron Falls bursting.
Probably getting up to extreme level at the moment. Yeah, never seen it this high.
The rushing river right in Rachel Ritchie's backyard.
Been buying water, food, easy to make food, open cans of baked beans.
Floating cows fished out of the river by locals.
That'll be one tired cow, but he's safe.
Emergency services also run off their feet.
Crews have become incredibly busy over the last 24 hours. Over 50 requests for our swift water rescue response.
Tennis and basketball courts looking more like a local pool. The message remains clear. These floodwaters are no playground.
We've had reports of people swimming and driving into floodwaters. Please don't do that. The roadways underneath may be severely damaged.
Like the Captain Cook and Palmerston highways, which have crumbled. The blocked roads also making it impossible for crews to fix blocked water intakes, meaning their storage is dwindling.
We've currently got about 30 hours left, so we're urging people to top up on water while they can.
While more than 10,000 are without power, and there's more rain to come, we're being warned what we saw today could be repeated tomorrow. Kate Lamb, Nine News.
Incredible pictures there. Nine's own Andrea Crothers is stuck in Lakeland, which is north of Cairns tonight. The roads there in and out of the region remain cut off by the floodwaters. She filed this report for us a short time ago.
Well, we've been stuck here in Lakeland, south of Cooktown, ever since Jasper hit. All roads in and out of this township simply cut off. The locals here, they are used to heavy rainfall during that wet season, but not even they expected it would be like this. 750 millimetres of rain dumped in just 5 days. That's around three quarters of their average annual rainfall. Jasper, once making landfall, was meant to move off to the Gulf. Instead, that trough has been stubbornly stationary, a spiralling heavy band of rain dumping across the tropical north coast as well as inland areas. Catchments which are already saturated, which is why we're seeing that flooding. Now, the Bureau says the conditions should start to ease from tomorrow, but I'm told we're in for another wet and wild 6 to 12 hours all the way from Daintree down to Innisfail.
And the Prime Minister has tonight responded to this emergency, saying his government is working closely with the Queensland government to ensure assistance is available to those who need it. Let's go straight to our weather expert, Garry Youngberry. Gaz, good evening to you. There are major flood warnings still in place for our far north as we go to air. What can you tell us on that?
Well, that's an incredible amount of rain, Wendy, falling across the far north. We've had, you know, more than half a metre of rain falling in 24 hours. Some of those weather stations now have recorded nearly what Melbourne record in a year's worth of rainfall. It's extending down here in the southeast with some instability. Brisbane at the moment, it's about the humidity. It feels like 32 degrees right now in the city, and there are some thunderstorms. There are multiple warnings around that extend from the Southern Downs, the scenic rim, Lockyer Valley, Ipswich as well. The radar capturing a few of those storm cells. Let's have a look. And the largest area of storms is in the Southern Downs. Reports of hailstones around Warwick, and those storms stretch up as far north as Clifton. There's a couple of smaller cells in the scenic rim, and we're not out of the woods yet. There is still the potential for further thunderstorms to even reach the city over the next few hours. This is the weather pattern that's sitting over southeast Queensland at the moment, and there is more to come. I'll have more details on your forecast for the week ahead a little later. Wendy.
See you soon, Gaz. Thank you for that. The SES has been called in to help clean up Brisbane after the last 2 days of wild storms. Thousands of residents have been left without power for days in the middle of this sweltering heatwave.
Hail in Bow Desert as superstorms smash the southeast.
This isn't quite what I'd expected.
Chris Fraser filming his Moroka home copping the brunt of it.
And we had some flying branches that smash a window, and my motorcycle unfortunately was speared by some flying trees.
This morning, the mammoth clean-up beginning after 2 days of wild wind and rain. SES crews helping clear debris from footpaths, checking in on residents.
Some homes here in Moroka have been without power for 2 days now. Crews out today working to get 3,500 properties back up and running.
Thankfully, I've been loaned a generator, so we've been able to run the fridge and a few fans.
Soaring temperatures taking a toll, even for those with power. A severe heatwave warning in place for the Gulf Country, Darling Downs, Granite Belt and southeast.
That will go on into tomorrow as well, but then looking like easing from Tuesday.
Beachgoers with the right idea.
It's ridiculously hot, so you get a swim to get out of the heat.
Just stay in the water and have fun.
We have got a very warm day temperature-wise. The water temp is absolutely refreshing, which we absolutely love.
And Yasmin Bonnel joins us live now. Yasmin, those storms brought a staggering amount of lightning last night.
They did, Wendy. Almost 300,000 lightning strikes recorded across the southeast overnight. Now, two of those struck two people in separate incidents. One of them was a 10-year-old girl on the Sunshine Coast. Tonight, she remains here at Queensland Children's Hospital fighting for her life in a critical condition.
All right, Yasmin, thank you for the update.